on Valentine's evening. And we got a whistle. Thought he had blown the whistle saying that he was going to redo the faceoff, but now we have a discussion with the officials here.
Linesmen can call penalties if they deem something to have happened. Talking to both referees, so it could be something that was said from the bench. It could be something that a player did.
I thought he had blown a whistle as if there was going to be a false start on the draw, but it's going to be a game misconduct against Antoine Vermette.
Abusive official. So yes, he can. A linesman can make the call there, and Vermette in the faceoff circle. You see that the puck's dropped. Oh, what did he swing at him for? My goodness, it looked like he took a bit of a swat at the linesman. That is shocking, to say the least.
He'll chase after it. Played back to the point. Weber to Markov, firing, tipped in front, and it goes wide. Now it is clear to the line. Markov will hold it in. They will get a whistle here, and it will be a hooking penalty, and I believe it is going against the Canadiens. And Andrew Shaw is the culprit.
Wow. Talk about letting the air out of the balloon for the Canadiens. And oh, we'll take a look where this penalty comes. And you get your stick up. Shaw's not happy as he destroys that stick in the box. You see the frustration. You're battling. You're trying to extend plays. And Shaw gets that stick parallel. Sometimes you get away with it at the end of games. Sometimes you don't. This time Shaw doesn't. He doesn't like the call. And the faceoff now comes all the way down to the Canadian zone.
And Shaw's going to get the gate here as well, and he still has extra words for referee Brad Watson as he goes across the ice. And there goes the stick rack.
Better spot for Patrick Maroon as it went over the shoulder of Markstrom and right underneath. And yes, there you go. Dorsett's going to get kicked out of this game. A 10-minute misconduct for that.
A water bottle squirted Patrick Maroon, who goaded him into doing it.
Okay, if I'm the Oilers here, I'd say forget about the penalty, give him an unsports.
Well, and that's it. The officials were looking for this. They put themselves in this situation. So now there's going to be a little delay as the linesmen are going to come over.
So Paul Maurice has been ejected.
Wow. I have not seen this. Well, you know what? And it's right. Don't just ignore it. Don't go to the bench. Don't look at the bench.
Skate away. You know what's happened in this game.
Toronto, Riley will block it, gets it off the glass and out. Puck hits the linesman. Now Subban's got a block and scores. Well, Subban arguing with the linesman, but the linesman is part of the play on the ice. So the puck hits him. That's an unfortunate break for Montreal, and Kane has the empty net goal.
Wow, what a tough break for the Montreal Canadiens. Subban is incensed, but I think he's got himself an unsportsmanlike penalty. And that's part of the game, though, and emotions are running high. Mo hard in this third period, and I didn't like that play by Gallagher trying to force that puck through the middle. And there's the puck that comes out of the zone. It's a puck that Subban, he's reading where it's going to go. He's going back to get it, but instead it goes off the linesman's skate into the back of the net. And like you mentioned, John, the linesman is.
Now Chris Weidman back to the puck. And then we get a whistle here.
So this might be a bench minor here, yep, guys. I think Mike Sullivan, I believe it was Mike Sullivan, as the referee points to the Penguins bench and says, we got you. Let's take a look here what the call is. no announcement. I know that he pointed to the bench.
I think he has been ejected.
Mike Sullivan has been ejected in this hockey game. I can't remember the last time I've ever seen this. Can you?
Ottawa 0-for-1 in the power play, did not get a shot on goal during their one and only man advantage. Wierkosz plays it across. Here's Carlson. Carlson up into the corner, and another penalty coming up against Montreal.
Markov and Carlson. Stone going right off, and that could be significant. He's looking at a 5-on-3, and he leaves the building in a hurry. And it's going to be PK Subban who's going to get the penalty for a slash. He's out of the game. Is he pointing? He's out of the game. PK Subban is gone.
It's a 5-minute major.
5-minute major for a slash? Off the faceoff, Stone coming in, and that's a penalty for sure, and it's a bad one, but chokes up on the stick to swing a little bit, but that's not as hard as a game misconduct needs to be in the playoffs. You have to get this right. Now, it looks bad there, but that is not a violent, and PK can't believe a penalty, forget about the five. Penalty, absolutely. Five, I'm not so sure, but you'd like to see them get together and make sure to get this right. A different referee, Dave Jackson, had a different view of it.